Alrighty, welcome to Railroads Online. We're going to be playing the beta today. Now, I was playing with Aardvark Games and Dark Wolf and a few others where Aardvark grabbed us from the Discord and said, hey, let's all do a beta round real quick, see how quickly we can make it to and from the yard. The beta spawn yard to the logging camp and everything, get a train up there. It was a successful learning lesson for don't do things without a plan. So, but before I downgrade to the main branch of the game, I thought I'd go ahead and do a quick play of the beta myself. See how badly I can screw it up on my own. Oh, let's see. Had a little bit of practice, but not much. Let's go ahead and grab that. I know I'm going to need turnouts. I'll try not to gripe too much about it and not compare it to the old track land system and try to be nice, give it a good shot, but the fair warning here is that I am still prefer the old track lane method, just because there's more creative things I can do with it that I can't do with just the splines. But that being said, let's see here. Is it straight to the right? And oh, wrong one. I should have done another left. Switch to the left. Let's see here. Track to the left. Turn out on the outside. There we go. And unfortunately, that's means my other turnout was not far enough up. Well, it means I'm going to have to start this over again. Alrighty, let's see here. Let's go there. Still got the straight stretch. I think here would. Let's see here. I'd say that tree leg's a good marker. That should be sufficient. Let's go ahead and let's see. I did switch to the left last time, so let's do the switch to the left again. Ready. Oh yeah, that'll work. That'll definitely work. Now, rather than waste time rotating the track around for a moment, I'm just going to go ahead and do it from this direction. Hit the 5 button. Run back here and reconnect here. And that will take care of doing the spawn yard. I'm pretty sure that's a basic spawn yard track if I've ever seen one. So, don't think I'm covering anything new, but I am trying to just get it done. I'm trying to not make long episodes this time, so. Let's see. Is this the Freight Depot special? I wonder if this will let me get away with doing it this way. Looks like it will, actually. Okay, line that up. Turn the straight mode on. Ooh, nice, fast, and pretty. Let's see here. Alrighty, there we go. Wow, this is a lot faster and easier to make than I thought. So, that being said, let's see about here. Can I do the same stunt over here? In case you're noticing, I I hit the number 5 for the circle mode and put turned it on, and apparently that locks it into a straight line. So, which I'm okay with that. By locking a straight line, I can actually line it up against two of these little boards here. Actually, I want to line it up with the, two boards, but at the same time, I also want to line it up with steps. Close enough. Whing! Spline the leg. Alrighty. There that. So, now that we got that taken care of. Actually, you know what? Probably need to go ahead and stretch this track out right here. That should be sufficient right about there. And then let's see here. I still like doing track switches to the left. And I need that to be on the inside. So yeah, I have to look at these pictures and think of them backwards. There we go. Track to the left. And get rid of that track. And I think before I do anything else, let's go ahead and give me a little bit of a track right here. Just enough to give me a little bit of clearance on the thing. And then we're going to, once again, left on the inside. Okay, there we go. Now, well, that didn't connect the way I wanted it. Okay, so if I'm going to do what I think I'm going to do, I probably need to go to a right-hand switch. And I'm going to try it. Inside, there we go. Let's see here. Perfect, that'll work. Okay. So let's get over here. Take the lockout mechanism off. Take the lock mechanism off. There we go. Then this should connect right here. And then while we're at connecting things, I'll just go ahead and connect that. And I'm guessing it should definitely connect to the turnout. Of course, it might if I built this turnout out far enough. Don't look like I built the turnout far enough out. Let's see if we can't bring that back in. Let's see. Now, let's see. That'll work. Let's get rid of this. And in theory, this should work. Let's see here. Alrighty. Takes care of that one, and then let's see here. hopefully this is better than a lot of the other videos, but like I said, this is just me doing the same thing as everyone else, playing my own, the beta version of Railroads Online myself. I've been mainly sticking to the main branch lately, so that's why I figured before I downgrade to the main branch again, I might as well go ahead and get a beta video made and out of the way. Plus, right here, I live in the backwoods of Tennessee, so I'm kind of used to seeing trees like this all the time, all the nice autumn leaves. So, I'll run the clock on a few more minutes here, so I guess I could go ahead and build the track out up here. Oop, wrong direction. Direction am I heading in anyways? Actually looks like a pretty good direction to get it curved to, and then I'm probably going to, depending on how just to the edge it is here. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good shot right there, so. Actually, how am I pointing? Yeah, good. So I think I'll go ahead and lock the straight line in, and like I said, we'll get this worked up to the sawmill at least and see about connecting it then. Because I'm going to try to start keeping my videos under 15 minutes to make them easier to upload and watch. I'm at the 11 minute and 30 second mark, so. Now, the reason I'm doing it this way is I do have a specific point in mind that I want to get to place the track down. Oop, went too far. Alrighty, so where am I at on the map? I am right there. And let's see how far up I got. May not got as far as I wanted to get before the timer runs out. But I'm 12 minutes and counting. So I'm down to just under 3 minutes on my time limit. Let's see. And I still haven't quite got where I want to. But as we're going down, I want to first of all thank Aardvark Games for letting me join him and the others the other day for a quick abuse of the beta program to see how quickly we could screw everything up. But between my OBS software wanting to update while I was trying to stream and too many of us building alternate track routes, it was something we're gonna have to actually plan out how we do it later on and try it again. From my own map. Actually, that seems like as good of a spot as any right about. Let's dead end our tree. There we go. Well, thank you for watching my first episode. I will see y'all down the track, and hopefully this series won't be too bad for me. Anyways, make sure you check out Aardvark Games' channel, and you can join him, me, and several others over on his Discord, where we're growing a really good community over there. Alt-Z.